Welcome to American Popular Song Today, changing the way you listen to music. If this is your first time here, every week Teddy and I give you the tools to hear more in the songs you love. If that sounds good to you, we hope you'll consider subscribing. But before we do anything else, we have to wish a very happy birthday to America! The 4th of July, Teddy and I are doing a very special episode of American Popular Song Today, emphasizing the American part. Today we're talking about that most popular of all American songs, our national anthem, the Star-Spangled Banner. The Star-Spangled Banner is not your average popular song. It's over 200 years old, so Teddy and I are gonna shake things up a bit and do a countdown of five things you probably didn't know about our national anthem. We'll start with number five after the theme song. Hit it! Started with our countdown, let me enlist the help of some friends and football enthusiasts to tell you a story. It's a little scary, a little violent, but be brave. Yesterday, my friend and I witnessed a very dangerous battle, the bombardment of an American fort. And during the battle, we could see the American flag waving over the fort to show that the Americans still controlled it. Carrie Underwood, how would you put that?
Whose broad stripes and bright stars through perilous fight, o'er the ramparts we watched, were so gallantly streaming.
That's good, that's much more concise. Anyway, so the battle continued into the night. Even though it was dark, we were still able to see the flag because of the light emitted from exploding bombs and rockets. Mariah, could you make that a little more poetic? Oh, that was good. But now it's morning. Specifically, what time is it, Luther Vandross?
Dawn's early light.
Right, so it's the crack of dawn, and I turn to my friend and I ask a favor. Now that the battle is over, look at the fort and please tell me, do you see the flag? Do the Americans still control the fort? Do you see the flag? It's such an important question that I'll ask it twice. Once at the beginning, Lady Gaga, would you please?
Say, can you see what so proudly we hail?
And again at the end. Beyonce, you're up.
Oh!
That's our story. We saw the flag yesterday, we saw it last night. Now please tell me, do you see it this morning? That story, of course, is our national anthem. And there are five things you probably didn't know about it. Our countdown begins now. Number five. Like the Ballad of John and Yoko, like I Took a Pill in Ibiza, like every Taylor Swift song you've ever heard, the Star-Spangled Banner is an autobiographical true story. Patriotic music, please. The year is 1814, and the United States is at war with Britain again. Things are not going so well. The British have marched on Washington and burned our new capital city to the ground. Enter Francis Scott Key, aka Frankie Key, aka Big Skinny Frankie. Frankie Key boards a British boat off the coast of Maryland to negotiate the release of some American prisoners. After which the British won't let him off the boat. So Frankie Key has to sit on this British boat and watch as the British bombard Fort McHenry, the American fort defending Baltimore. But when the sun rises and the smoke clears, Frankie Key looks out and sees that somehow the American flag is still waving over Fort McHenry, and that means the Americans have withstood the attack and saved the city. Huzzah! Super emotional, he immediately writes a poem about what just happened, about seeing the flag during the battle and waiting to see if it would still be waving over Fort McHenry in the morning. Thinking about that moment in history, about Frankie Key sitting on the boat waiting to see if America had survived, adds to the emotion and makes it so much more cinematic. Things you probably didn't know about our national anthem. Number 4. Every performance of the national anthem is a dialogue. Whoever sings the national anthem makes a request. Please tell me, do you see the flag? As I mentioned, that request is made twice. Once at the beginning, Dixie Chicks.
Oh, say can you see by the dawn's early light what so proudly we hailed.
And once at the end, Faith Hill. Good job, everyone! You might not have realized it, but when you cheer at the end of the national anthem, you're answering the question. Your cheer is a way of saying, yes, the flag is still there. That dialogue between the singer and the listener is a beautiful thing because it underscores what America is all about. America is something we do together. Now, if you think about it, you might see why our tradition of looking at the flag while singing the national anthem makes no sense. The whole point of the song is that the singer doesn't look. Rather, the singer asks a friend to look and tell him. If we really wanted to perform it correctly, the singer would cover their eyes or turn away and rely on their fellow Americans, everyone listening to the song and looking at the flag, to answer the question with a big cheer at the end. So next time the anthem starts to play, decide, are you going to sing along or listen? Are you going to be the one making the request or answering it? And I propose you should look at the flag or not, depending on the role you choose. Number 3. The national anthem asks two questions in one. Jennifer Hudson, would you give us that last line, please?
Oh, say does that star-spangled banner ride o'er the land of the free and the
There are two questions being asked. There's the question we talked about before, do you see the flag? And another question, is the flag flying over a country that's still free and still brave? The double meaning is a bit of wordplay. Now, we love America. So many of you may be thinking, if not shouting at the screen, Matt, of course we're free. Of course we're brave. But I'll tell you, Benjamin Franklin and the other founders were very concerned that over time we might lose our freedoms, not in one fell swoop, but by erosion. It's why, when asked what kind of government had been formed for the new country, Benjamin Franklin said, a republic, if you can keep it. So when the Star-Spangled Banner asks in that last line, does the flag still wave over the land of the free and the home of the brave? It's asking us to check in, to think about the state of our freedoms and whether we're being brave enough to keep them robust. Think about that the next time you hear the national anthem. Number 2. There are more verses. In fact, there are 4 verses and we only ever sing the first one. This got a little attention because of some controversial lyrics in the 3rd verse. No refuge could save the hireling and slave from the terror of flight or the gloom of the grave. In those lyrics, Francis Scott Key is celebrating America's triumph over 2 kinds of people who fought for the British in the War of 1812. People who fought for money and slaves. He's really talking about American slaves who fought for the British because the British promised them their freedom. It was a recruiting tactic the British had used in the American Revolution as well. Many people think that any lyrics vilifying American slaves don't belong in our national anthem. And I agree. It's perverse, particularly as Americans, to celebrate the defeat of enslaved people fighting for their freedom. Let's just keep it to the first verse. Finally, the number 1 thing you don't know about the Star-Spangled Banner, and really never can know, is the time signature. The song was written in 3/4 time, which means there are 3 beats in every measure. That's the most common way to sing it. It's what Mariah Carey did at her Super Bowl performance.
Whose broad stripes and bright stars pull up their own less high
It's how Kelly Clarkson sang it at her Super Bowl performance.
By the dawn's early light, what so proudly we hailed.
It's what Carrie Underwood, Lady Gaga, the Dixie Chicks, and about a million others have done. But every now and then, someone will sing it with four beats in a measure. Listen to Jennifer Hudson.
Oh, say, can you see by the dawn's early light what so bright?
Pretty cool, right? But here's the thing. Jennifer Hudson, Beyonce Knowles, Faith Hill, they all started the anthem with four beats to a measure, but then changed to three beats in a measure for the last line. Listen!
That our flag was still there. Oh, say does that star-spangled.
She's just so good. Suddenly switching from four beats in a measure to three beats in a measure makes the music feel like it's picking up and moving along to a dramatic finish. Finally, there is that rare performer who will attempt to sing the national anthem with four beats in a measure all the way to the end, relying on nothing but their own power to bring it to a dramatic close. The best example of that? Well, you've been waiting for me to play her this entire video, so ladies and gentlemen, without further ado, singing the national anthem with four beats in a measure at the beginning, all the way through the end, Whitney Houston! Listen to the end.
That our flag was still there. Oh, say that star-spangled banner yet waves.
Others, whose names I won't mention out of respect, have attempted it, but none have pulled off four beats to a measure all the way to the end like Whitney Houston. So next time you hear the national anthem, pay attention. Are there three beats or four beats? And does the singer change it for the last line? That's it for this week. Teddy and I really hope you've enjoyed this special episode of American Popular Song Today. We'll get back on track with Wednesday releases on July 11th, and we hope we'll see you then. Thanks for watching, and don't forget to subscribe. Subscribing makes you feel good inside, so don't forget to subscribe to our channel. And happy 4th of July!